Hi there, this video comes with some exercise files and a cheat sheet for Photoshop. There'll be a link in the description for those. Okay, it's part of my larger course, which you can go and check out. There'll be a link there as well. All right, enjoy the video. Hi there, in this first of the retouching videos, we're gonna look at ContentAware Fill. And it gets used for doing things like this, ready, steady, magic. It's really good for those first steps where you need to block out some objects before you get into some of the finer details. Let's look at this one. Hello text, goodbye text. Cool, huh? It's quick, it's easy, it's super awesome, and goodbye man. This is one of those Photoshop magic things where you're just like, how, why? It's so good. Let's learn how to do it now in Adobe Photoshop. First thing is let's open up a bunch of images. Let's go to File, Open, and in your exercise files, we're now in this 09 retouching folder. I want you to open up all four of these. So we've got ContentAware Fill 1, 2, 3, and 4. All right, we're gonna start with kind of like easy to hard. So we're gonna start with this 01 from Molvestida magazine. Okay, we looked at this earlier on when we're doing vibrance. Let's say the clients come back and said, actually, I want these three things removed. Now, first of all, we need to select them. And in this case, this is one of the few times I use the lasso tool. I showed you it earlier on. This is one of the times I use it a lot, okay, when I'm trying to remove things. Click and hold down, and we'll just use the, instead of the regular lasso tool, we're gonna use the polygonal one. Polygonal, it's one of those. And with this one, we click once, click again, and you just kind of work your way around, clicking once, I'm not holding anything down, I'm just kind of working my way around this, including the shadow, okay, and being back here. You can be really vague with the selections with this tool, it's pretty amazing. And let's go to edit, and we'll go to fill. Now this thing is called ContentAware Fill, and it's hidden in fill, and it's amazing. And so many people don't discover it because it's kind of hiding in here. Click on fill, we've used black, white, so yours might need to be changed to ContentAware. Then click okay, kick back, relax, and magic, cool, huh? I'm gonna go to select, deselect, and it's done a pretty amazing job. There's a little, tiny bit of something in there, but man, it's hard to tell. Let's do it again for the lipstick. Okay, so I'm gonna click once, click again. I'm gonna go around, just clicking around the outside. Edit fill, ContentAware, give it a click, magic. I do love that. Such an easy trick to show people. Deselect. Now it works really, really well with small things in a larger picture. If I try and remove this bag, it's gonna freak out. I'll show you how much it's gonna freak out. Let's go around the edges. I'm just clicking once. Gives it a good go. Like it's pretty amazing how much of a go it gives it. Okay, let's go to edit. Fill, ContentAware, click OK, and it's pretty good. Okay, it's a good starting point at least. You can start to see all the kind of weirdness going on. Depending on the quality of your video, you might be on a really like slow internet connection. You might not see it and it might look perfect. But trust me, it's a little bit manky, a little bit. All right, let's move into another one. So ContentAware Fill 2. This one's not particularly harder. We're going to use just the rectangle marquee tool here because it's a nice easy part. It could be graffiti on a wall. Now this is gonna work mainly because it's an uneven wall. If it was a perfectly well laid wall with no kind of defects over it, it might look not as good. Let's go to edit, let's go to fill and get ready, get steady, go. Cool, huh? Now deselect, it kind of fudges the edges. Like there is no way of telling where the defects are in this wall because the wall's so forgiving. Let's look at some less forgiving work under ContentAware Fill 3. This one here has too many like geometric shapes and there's too many kind of differences here. Those first two examples were nice ones where the background was all consistently the same texture. This one here is gonna be okay. I'm gonna go back to my lasso tool. I'm gonna zoom in. Now this is where you might spend a little bit more time being closer because the background is so different. So I'm gonna go around them and spend a little bit more time clicking. I'll get the editor to speed this up. All right, we're back. That took me all of about a minute. So we're gonna go to edit, fill, and go. ContentAware Fill and go again. Let's hit deselect. It's pretty good. You know, there's some obvious defects there, but at a glance, there's like, you can see the edge of that's not great, but Man, it's pretty close. There's a shadow that we probably need to remove off him. But in all honesty, other than now grabbing the rectangle tool and kind of grabbing bits, copying and pasting them, moving them over with the move tool and trying to like maybe feather the edges, that's where I go to next. And that's the only real other way. So it's done a pretty neat job. Now, before I move on to the next bit, I just want to show you, like, we haven't used the lasso tool very much and you might be finding it quite problematic. So I'm going to move the person back in and I'm going to show you a couple of things you might run into with the lasso tool. Okay, so if you are finding this polygonal lasso tool super hard to use, just go to this lasso tool, the first one, just click hold and you can just drag around it if you've got a steady enough hand. Okay, that will work fine. But if you do really want to master this polygonal, I'm gonna stop saying it now, the one with the straight edges. Okay, watch this. If I click once, and then sometimes if I get close to the edges, it really wants to do this. I'll just show you because when I teach people, this happens all the time. They kind of end up in no man's land. They're like, oh man, how do I get back? The trick is once you've finished, got lost, hit escape on the keyboard. That's your I'm giving up, I'm gonna start again button. Okay, escape on the keyboard. Okay, the other thing is that if you do go all the way around, I'm cheating here by doing it in nice big chunks. You get back here and you're like, it won't finish. Why can't I find the end? What you can do is just double click and it will find the end and join it up for you. So those are the two things you might run into when you're using that tool. You can use any tool. You can use the quick mask selection and go into that select and mask and expand it. That could be a good way of doing it, but I don't think you're going to get much better results. Now this last example here, 04, this has the same problem as the last one. I want you to practice on this one though. Go around the edges with a selection tool, any tool you like, see if you can get rid of this young man. He's ruining our shot. How dare he get in there? All right, that's gonna be it for Content Aware Fill. I love this tool. And when I'm retouching and kind of removing things, it's a really easy way to get rid of the kind of first bulk stuff. You might have a great image, except for that one thing that got in the shot. It might be something that you left there or rubbish on the ground. Content Aware Fill is a nice, quick and easy way to retouch. All right, I will see you in the next retouching video.
Hi, it's me again. If you enjoyed the video, a thumbs up really helps me and what I'm doing. Also consider subscribing to my YouTube channel because I release a video like this every week. Also know that this is part of my larger course. Okay, so this is like a free part of it. There's a larger course called Photoshop Essentials. So you could go check that out. There's a link in the description for that full course. Also know that there's exercise files. Those are free to download. Go check that out, link in the description. Another link in the description will be the cheat sheet. So I make it like a PDF cheat sheet for Photoshop with all the tips and tricks you can print off and stick next to your computer and be more awesome. Link in the description. Yeah, all right, that's enough. Hi, Dada.